Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to explain you the types of binary tree. I am giving an introduction to the different types of binary tree. Before moving to binary tree, I would like to explain different types of data structures. They are mainly primitive and non-primitive. Will focus on this side of the data structure, where non-primitive data structures are linear data structure as well as non-linear data structure. From non-primitive data structure, I am going to focus on non-linear data structures. Now, well-known examples of non-linear data structures are trees and graph, on which I am going to focus on tree part of the data structure. From that trees, I am going to focus on a binary tree and its different types. So now, what is binary tree? Basically, binary tree is a nonlinear data structure. Tree is a data structure in which each parent node can have at most two children, because it is a binary tree. Binary means two. So maximum two children every node, every parent will be having is nothing but a binary tree. So every parent may have either zero node as a child, one single node as a single child, or maximum two nodes as two children to every parent node. If this condition is satisfied by any of the tree, then we can say that the tree is a binary tree. So this is the image, or this is the example of a binary tree, where you can see that, say, the one is a root node, as the first node of every tree is a root node. This root node is having maximum two children, that is 12 and 9. You can see 12 is having maximum two children, 5 and 6. But now see the example 6, or the node 9, or a parent node 9, both are having a single child, that is 9 is having child 8 and 6 is having child 4. Or these are the leaf nodes, that is 2, 3, 4 and 8 are the leaf nodes who are not having any child, so that's why these are called as a leaf nodes. These are the basic terminologies of the tree. Now we will move forward. For the first type of a tree is nothing but a full binary tree. The name itself suggests that this is a binary tree which is full. Full means what? A full binary tree is a special type of binary tree in which every parent node has either two or no children. So the restriction is that maximum two children must be there, otherwise there should not be any children. A single child is not allowed in this full binary tree. So this is the example of full binary tree, where you can see that every node is having either no child, that is the nodes 5, 3, 4 and 9 with the no child, that is leaf node, or the intermediate node, parent node, are having, or a root node in the case of node 1. All these are having maximum two children. A single child is not allowed. So one is having the children 12 and 9. Left child is 12, right child is 9. 12 is having left child as 5, right child as 6. 6 is having left child as 3 and right child as 4. So in this way, if this type of tree is there, then we can say that the tree is a full binary tree. So here I need to repeat, or I would like to repeat, that the node, parent node, is having either 2 or no children. If this is the case, then we can say that the tree is a full binary tree. Now let's see what is complete binary tree. So complete binary tree is just like a full binary tree. Only the difference is that every level must be completely filled. So while insertion of the nodes in a complete binary tree, the level must be completely filled. All the leaf elements must lean towards the left, means while insertion the nodes in the complete binary tree, we need to start from the left of every level. And the last and main difference, that the leaf element might not have a right sibling. That is, a complete binary tree doesn't have to be a full binary tree, because while insertion a node one by one, if the last node is only the left child of its parent node and no right child is available, it is allowed in this binary tree and completely it fills the levels one by one. That's why this is called as complete binary tree, but this cannot be the full binary tree. So this is the example of a complete binary tree where 1 is having maximum 2 children, 12 is also having maximum 2 children, but the 9 is a node which is having a single child, but it should be the left child. If a single child is there, it should be the left child. No right child is allowed if the left child is not present. This is the main condition of a complete binary tree. Now we'll see how to identify a full and complete binary tree. Full binary tree and complete binary tree. Very first thing, a root node is having 3 children, which is not at all allowed in binary tree. If it is not a binary tree, it cannot be a full binary tree as well as it cannot be a complete binary tree. Move to the next example, where this is a binary tree with the every node is having maximum 0, 1 or maximum 2 children, minimum 0, 1 or maximum 2 children. So this is a binary tree, but is it a full binary tree? No, as the node 9 is having a single child, which is not allowed in full binary tree. But is it a complete binary tree? Yes, if a single child is there, it must be a left child. So the condition is satisfied. So that's why this is the tree which is complete binary tree. Let's see more two examples. This is a tree where every node is having 0, 1 or maximum 2 children. So that's why this is a binary tree. Is it a full binary tree? No, because 9 is a node having a single child. That's why it is not a full binary tree. Is it a complete binary tree? Again, no, because the node 9 is a node, parent node, which is having a right child. And it's not allowed in a complete binary tree, because all the child will lean towards to the left child of the every parent node. It should get filled first of all the left child, then the right child. It's not allowed that the parent is having single child and it is a right child. It's not allowed. So that's why this is not a complete binary tree. And this is the example where this tree satisfies all the conditions. That is, a node is having 0, 1 or maximum 2 children. Every node is having maximum 2 children, so that's why it is a full binary tree. And as well as, if it is a full binary tree, it is a complete binary tree as well. So here we can see that the tree is a full tree as well as a complete tree, complete binary tree. So here we need to keep in mind one point, that every full binary tree is a complete binary tree, but every complete binary tree cannot be, or it can't be, a full binary tree. This is the example for the same, that this is a complete binary tree, but this is not a full binary tree. But this is the example where this is a full binary tree, and that's why it is a complete binary tree as well. Now we'll see how to construct the complete binary tree. So whenever we want to construct a complete binary tree, we need to take the first element as a root node, that is at the level 1. First level, first element. Then whenever you want to insert a second element, it should be the left child of a root node, and third element will be the right child of a root node. So in this way, your second level is also completed. If you want to insert next two elements, then you need to start with the children of a left node of a previous level, that is a second level. Again, if you want to insert a next two nodes, then children of a right node of the second level. So in this way, here you are going to complete the third level as well. And after repeating all these steps, you will be able to construct a complete binary tree. Here I have explained one example of construction of complete binary tree. I am having different nodes in my array, and the first node will be my root node. The second node I want to insert will be a left child of root node, that is left child of 12. A third node will get the position of as a right child of root node. Now here you can see that this is the level which is completely filled in this binary tree. Now I will move forward. I want to insert a new one more node in my tree. So here 5 is inserted as a left child of the left parent from the previous level. So 5 is inserted as a left child of node 12. Next, if I want to insert 6, that will be the right child of node 12. And the last, if I want to insert 10, so I will insert it as a left child of node 9. So in this way I can construct a complete binary tree. Now if I am going to construct a complete binary tree from the array, so there must be a relationship between tree elements available in your constructed binary tree and the array indices from which you have constructed the complete binary tree. So here I am going to explain you the same relationship. Complete binary tree has an interesting property that we can use to find the children and the parent of any node. So what is that property? So property is, if the index of any element in array is I, the element in the index that is 2i plus 1 will become the left child, and immediate next node that is 2i plus 2 will become the right child. And if I want to identify the parent from the given index, for that I need to apply a formula like I minus 1 that is divided by 2. From this you will come to know what is the parent is present at which index position of your array. Now let's see one example, that if my root is at the 0th position, every time you need to put your root at the 0th position itself. So for any I, the left child of I will be at the position array of 2i plus 2, the right child will be present at array position 2i plus 2, left child will be present a 2i plus 1 position, and right child will be present at a 2i plus 2 position. And for the ith element, I want to find out where is the parent available. So for this the formula is a I minus 1 divided by 2. Here I have given some example. The tree which is just now we have constructed from the array, we are having their indices and we are having the constructed binary tree, complete binary tree I would like to say. So now let's consider for the index 0. For the index 0, the node is present which is nothing but 1. So if I want to find out the element present at the index I, index 0, that is 0 to multiply by 2, 2i plus 1 is nothing but the index position 1, and at the index position 1 is nothing my left child, that is nothing but 12. Next, if I want to find out a right child of 1, 2i plus 2 will give the position of the right child, that is 9 is nothing but a right child of 1 which is present at position 2. So here you can get that the position 2i, that is 2 into 0 is nothing but 0 plus 2 is nothing but 2. So the element present at the index position 2 is nothing but the right child of 1. In the same way, if I want to find out, first of all we'll see the parent. If I want to find out the parent of 9, say if I want to find out a parent of 9 which is present at which position, so what I'll do, 2 minus I, 2 is nothing but the position of the element whose parent you want to find out. So 9 is present at position 2, so I minus 1, that is 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1, and 1 divided by 2 it's 0. So at the index 0 position, the number is present 1 is nothing but the parent of number 9. Now let's go forward for another example, like to find out the left and right child, to find out the position of left and right child of node 12. So node 12 is present at position index 1. Here you can see that 12 is present at position 1. So 2i plus 1, that is 2 into 1 is 2 plus 1 is nothing but a 3. So here you can see that left child of 12 is nothing but present at index 3 is nothing but 5. Here index 3, the number is present 5. You can see that 5 is nothing but the left child of number 12 or node 12. In the same way, 2i plus 1, that is 2 into 2, 2 into 1 is 2, plus 2 is nothing but 4. So index 4 position will be having the right child of node 12. So is 6 is present at the right child, as a right child of number 12. And the same way, if I want to find out if my 12 is a child node and who is the parent of this child, if I want to find out, for this the formula is I minus 1 divided by 2. So I minus 1, that is I, the position of I is nothing but 1. 1 minus 1 is 0 divided by 2. So the index is 0. So the parent is present at position 0. So in this way, you can find out any of the child present for any of the parent, as well as any of the parent present for any of the child, if the array elements are there available and correctly you have constructed the complete binary tree. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the contents and the video, please like the video and subscribe my channel Tech Talks and share it with your friends. Do not forget to bell, keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of my new videos. Here I am giving you some more shortcut links for data structures as well as related to microprocessors. Thank you.